Or a story will premiere this weekend, and box office expectations are high.
Yeah, considering what we're seeing outside the TCL Chinese Theater tonight, Doug Kolk is with fans already camping out. Doug.
You know, Micah and Cher, believe it or not, this dedicated crew, they all know each other, and they've been doing it for years. As a matter of fact, Rick here, you've been doing it for how long?
Since 99.
That's how many Star Wars?
Gosh, how many are we at now? This is like six.
Six.
Yeah.
Has it been worth it every time?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. You know, we've been doing this for a charity since the beginning. And since 99, we've raised approximately $115,000 for Starlight Children's Foundation. We're really proud of the work we do there. But and we also get to create this amazing family here.
Oh, that's awesome, Rick. Congrats. Did anybody tell you you look like George Lucas?
I've gotten that once or twice, yeah.
Well, speaking of George Lucas, we also chatted with the very busy cast.
That you're slipping up.
Long before Donald Glover had the country's top song,
this is America,
hit stand-up comedy specials,
ow! And she'd be like, I just had a dream where you were sleeping with another woman.
Or his Emmy Award-winning performance in Atlanta.
Hey, man, you gotta get up.
He started as a writer on 30 Rock.
And I'm talking to you clearly, gay kid. Who told?
With bit parts.
Don't eat in costume.
And then hit it big with Community.
Shamalama Ding Dong.
I couldn't believe I was in a pilot in L.A. I was like, I mean, everybody told me at the time, they were like, you're lucky that to be, and I was like, I know, I am lucky.
To say his career has blown up would be an understatement, considering he's now in solo.
Everything you've heard about me is true.
Resurrecting the classic character of Lando Calrissian in a Star Wars story.
You might wanna buckle up, baby.
I actually love Star Wars. Like, I really grew up on it. It's a really big part of me. And, like, to be a part of it, it's like, yeah, like, that's, I feel like that, yeah, that's success.
Woody Harrelson now finds himself busier than ever.
That's all coming to an abrupt close. After this, after this press thing, I'm just teeing up a long lollygag.
Fresh off an Academy Award nomination for his performance in Three Billboards.
I don't think those billboards is very fair.
He too joins the Star Wars family.
You're in this life for good.
But is looking forward to the time off.
Okay, we're gonna start with the European vacation.
Are
yes.
You?
Yeah, yeah.
With the farm?
Yeah.
Are you all gonna do it?
Yeah, yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, really cool.
I can hang out with you in London.
I would love that.
That would be incredible.
And that brings us to these two.
Yes.
Paul Bettany is the voice of Iron Man.
You've experienced a severe anxiety attack.
So you know what he's been up to. And then there's Emilia Clarke.
Dracarys.
Or as the world knows her as... Khaleesi.
But what is clear is that you
We're
and
the
I...
best.
Aren't the best. That you and I, the reason that these, you know,
yeah.
franchises are doing so well.
We should have shares in popcorn, essentially, is what we're saying.
All right, so we've got, what, 20 hours now to the first showing? One more night. You guys got this?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Yes, we do.
Oh, yeah.
No problem,
sure.
Yeah, no problem at all.
Not
an issue.
We'll send it back to you guys.
Something tells me they'd stay longer if they could.
If they could, they would.
Doug, thank you. Coming up in Health.